Hello, my name is Laiany and I'm going to present the paper entitled Towards a More Accurate Time-of-Flight Distance Sensor to be Applied in a Mobile Robotics Application. This presentation is divided in introduction, objective, setup for acquiring data, results, conclusion and future work, and lastly, acknowledgements. The time-of-flight technology is widely applied in mobile robots, like obstacle avoidance, mapping, objects and environmental reconstruction, collision prevention. In this principle, there is a modulated signal that is sent to an object by a emitter, and then the signal is reflected and captured by a receptor. The distance is calculated based on the time that the signal is reflected. In this paper, we used the VL53L0X board, which has a time-of-flight distance sensor based on infrared signal, which has high accuracy, fast, compact, and low cost. So the objective of this paper is a field-of-view analysis of a time-of-flight sensor, which will be applied in a mobile robotics application. It was performed three tests in different conditions. For the first one, the sensor moved horizontally over a step in order to analyze the sensor behavior facing a abrupt difference of distance. For the second test, the sensor moved in different angles, keeping the distance from the target. And in the last test, it was applied a camera sensitive to infrared signals to visualize the field of view. It was applied a collaborative robot as a manipulator in order to guarantee repetitive movements with speed and precision. Here we have the results for the first test, and the gray line represents where the step begins, and all the measures were consistent with the calculated distances. It's possible to see how the curves are accented in small distance and soft for a long distance, which is expected because according to the distance increase, the field of view of the sensor increases too. More points outside of the step are reached. The space between each curve also kept approximately the same, representing a good sensor response. For the second test, when the sensor is perpendicular with the target plane at 0 degrees, the values measured by the sensor were close to calculated values, and according to the inclination of the sensor in both sides, there is a distortion in the measures, which was expected too. It was performed two tests, the sensor moving back and forth and sideways, in order to analyze the sensor behavior according to the position of the emitter and receptor. It's possible to conclude that it's more symmetry in sideways movements than in back and forth, which must be taken into consideration when you are developing and designing a mobile robot. For the last test, it was possible to visualize the sensor field of view, and the geometers were very consistent with the data sheet and calculated values. In the first figure, for example, at 50 mm of distance from the target, the circle reaches approximately 2 squares in the paper. Each square has 10 mm, totalizing 20 mm, which is close to 22.2 mm in the table. And all the other values were very consistent. And in these other figures, it's possible to see the deformation of the field of view according to the inclination of the sensor, which was also expected. As conclusion, it was possible to analyze the field of view of the time-of-flight sensor as well as its behavior, face an abrupt difference of distance, and different inclinations too. These results and model will be applied in a simulation environment, assisting not only in mobile robot development, but also in educational contexts. As future work, tests with different types of surface will be performed, and then the sensor results will be applied in a simulation environment. I would like to thank FCT for supporting this project, and thank you so much for your attention.